The shit people do. I watched a thing the other day on Crazy Eddie. Do you remember Crazy Eddie?
Yeah, when Crazy Eddie. His prices are insane.
Did you know what Crazy Eddie did?
Well, tell everybody who Crazy Eddie was.
Crazy Eddie was a guy that had stores in all five boroughs of New York. Wholesale outlets.
TVs.
Stereos, TVs, and everything like that. I was watching MSNBC, Greed. They have a series called
there
Greed.
He is. Let me hear this, motherfucker.
I forgot. TVs, VCR, stereo systems, telephones, telephone answering machines, anything and everything in home entertainment, and lots of home appliances too. Remember, we are not undersold. We will not be undersold. We cannot be undersold, and we mean it. Santa knows that the best deals in town are at Crazy Eddie's during Crazy Eddie's Christmas blowout blitz. See Crazy Eddie now. His prices are insane.
He's wearing a Santa Claus outfit. He's going fucking crazy with fake snow in the background.
He hit it out of the park.
Didn't he go to Israel?
He went to Israel to flee. But the most brilliant thing he did was he took either, check fact me on this. He took either his nephew, his son-in-law, somebody that he was related to through blood, put him through college so he could get a job at the IRS so they could figure out how to rob from the IRS. This is how fucking insane this guy was. I'm watching this diet and how they got Crazy Eddie.
Oh, my God.
Right. Crazy Eddie fled after he started just buying boxes. You know how you remember years ago you'd be driving in New York and there was some guy selling stereo speakers?
Yeah.
And then you'd take them home and it was two bricks?
Yep.
Well, he did the same thing to investors. He took boxes, filled them up with bricks, and just stocked them in a warehouse, and then he went public. So he got everybody to come down and look at all his inventory and all these fact checkers. They're checking boxes with bricks in them.
Whoa.
And he had, five fucking warehouses all around. They were all fake, and he got all this money. He fled to Israel, and he fled for a while, but they knew he was a pussy hound. Right? So they got him like Escobar style. They got him on the phone, like I'm going to the store, something crazy. And what they did was they put a blonde on the side of the road with a miniskirt. And they knew eventually he would drive by and stop.
No.
And he stopped. That's how they nailed him.